Hi viewers, welcome to my channel SM Edu Talk. This is Dr. S. Mallikarjunan. In the previous videos, we have seen projection of points in detail. In this video, we are going to see what is a line, its different positions, projections, and drawing procedure. If you have not subscribed the channel yet, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified. Okay, let us move into the video. In this video, we are going to see projection of lines. First, what is a line? Line is a single dimensional entity. That is, the drawing entity line has only length. It does not have any other dimensions like height, width, etc. There are two types of line, straight line and curved line. A line joining any two points along the shortest path is called as straight line. If it does not use the shortest path, it is called as a curved line or curve. We are going to see projection of straight lines only. Like projection of points, projection of lines is also completely based on multi-view orthographic projection. Those who are watching my videos continuously can understand multi-view orthographic projection, projection of points, etc. Others, please watch my previous videos for better understanding. I have given the links for those videos and the channel link in the description. There are four types of multi-view orthographic projection, namely first angle projection, second angle projection, third angle projection, and fourth angle projection. We have used all type of projections, that is all the four quadrants in projection of points, but in projection of lines, as per syllabus, we will use first angle projection only. That is, the given object line should be kept in first quadrant to see its various projections or views. In this first quadrant, front view should be drawn above the XY line for above HP condition and on the XY line for on HP condition. Similarly, top view should be drawn below the XY line for in front of VP condition and on the XY line for on VP condition. Moreover, you can draw only front view and top view of a line, no need to draw side view. We can position the given straight line in four different ways. They are parallel to both the planes, parallel to one plane and perpendicular to the other, parallel to one plane and inclined to the other, inclined to both the planes. Among the four positions, you will have questions only from the fourth position. But to understand the fourth position, you have to go through the other three. Now, we are going to see one by one in detail. The first one, parallel to both the planes. You are seeing the first quadrant of the principal planes. In projection of lines, line is the given object. So, a line PQ is kept in the first quadrant. Look at the line, how it is kept. This is parallel to both the planes VP and HP. It means both the endpoints P and Q of the line are kept equidistanced from both the planes. The line PQ's front view is projected to the VP as P' Q'. Its top view is projected to the HP as PQ. Rotate the HP to 90 degrees to get both the views on the same plane. It should be brought to the drawing sheet like this. Here, the front view P' Q' should come above the XY line and be parallel to the XY line. The top view PQ should come below the XY line and be parallel to the XY line. Whenever a line is parallel to a plane, then the view on that plane has got the same length of the line. Here, the line PQ is parallel to both the planes. Hence, the length of the line PQ is equal to the length of the front view and top view. That is, capital PQ equal to small P' Q' that is equal to small pq. Let us see the meaning of first quadrant conditions. Above HP condition is used to mention the vertical distance between the line PQ and HP. In front of VP condition is used to mention the horizontal distance between the line PQ and VP. After rotating the HP to 90 degree, you can see that both the views are on the single plane. The plane records only the views, not the real object. So here you should know how the above HP and in front of VP conditions can be used to position the views in the respective places. While drawing the projections of the line PQ in the drawing sheet, using the above HP condition, you can position the front view above the XY line. Similarly, using the in front of VP condition, you can position the top view below the XY line. If you are able to visualize the line in principal planes, you can understand where each view should come. No need to mug up anything. But if you are not able to visualize, you need to mug up quadrant conditions and the placement of views. Second position, parallel to one plane and perpendicular to the other. This position has two subtypes. The first one is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. The line PQ is kept in the first quadrant. This time, I think you get an idea about the position of the line PQ by simply looking at. Okay, I will explain. This line is kept parallel to HP. That is, its two endpoints P and Q are kept equidistant from HP. At the same time, the line PQ is perpendicular to VP. That is, line makes 90 degree with the VP. When you look at the line standing in front, the line looks like a point. That's why the front view of the line PQ is projected to VP as a point. But the line has two endpoints. The front endpoint Q is visible to our eyes, but rear endpoint P is not visible. In practice, invisible entity names should be written within bracket. So front view is named as Q dash bracket P dash. Here Q dash represents visible endpoint and bracket P dash represents invisible endpoints. When you look at the line from the top, the line PQ looks like a line. That's why the top view of the line PQ is projected to HP as a line PQ. After rotating the HP to 90 degree, you can see that both the views are on the same plane. While drawing the views in the drawing sheet, top view PQ should be drawn first, because top view PQ's length is equal to the known length of the given line PQ. Then project the top view above the XY line to get the front view. Second subtype is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. The line PQ is kept parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP in the first quadrant. Its front view is projected as a line P'Q' to VP, and top view is projected as a point P bracket Q to HP. Here P represents visible endpoint and bracket Q represents invisible endpoint. After rotating the HP to 90 degree, you can see that both the views are on the same plane. While drawing the views in the drawing sheet, front view P dash Q dash should be drawn first, because length of the front view P dash Q dash is equal to the known length of the given line PQ. Then project the front view below the XY line to get the top view. Third position of line is parallel to one plane and inclined to the other. This position also has two subtypes. The first one is parallel to VP and inclined to HP. The line PQ is kept in the first quadrant in a position mentioned just now. Its front view is projected as a line P'Q' to VP. The line PQ is parallel to VP. That's why its two endpoints are equidistanced from VP. You can see that the length of the projector capital P small p dash is equal to capital Q small q dash. Similarly, top view is also projected as a line small pq to HP. The line PQ is inclined to HP. So its two endpoints are at different heights from HP. You can see that the length of the projector PP is not equal to the length of the projector QQ. After rotating the HP to 90 degree, you can see that both the views are on the same plane. While drawing the views in the drawing sheet, front view P dash Q dash should be drawn first, because length of the front view P dash Q dash is equal to the known length of the given line PQ. It means front view P dash Q dash has the actual or true length. Then project the front view below the XY line to get the top view PQ. The length of the top view PQ is less than the actual length of the given line PQ. So top view's length is termed as apparent length. Second subtype is parallel to HP and inclined to VP. The line PQ is kept parallel to HP and inclined to VP in the first quadrant. Its front view is projected as a line P dash Q dash to VP, and its top view is also projected as a line PQ to HP. After rotating the HP to 90 degree, you can see that both the views are on the same plane. While drawing the views in the drawing sheet, top view PQ should be drawn first, because top view PQ has the true length and it is known to us. But front view P dash Q dash has the apparent length and completely unknown to us. We can start drawing a view with known dimensions only. That's why top view is drawn first. After drawing the top view PQ, project it above the XY line to get the front view P dash Q dash. Finally, fourth position of line is inclined to both the plane. Here, the line PQ is kept at an angle to both the reference planes VP and HP in the first quadrant. Its front view is projected as a line P dash Q dash to VP, and its top view is also projected as a line PQ to HP. Whenever a line is parallel to a plane, then the view on that plane has got the same length or true length of the line. We can start drawing a view only if it has the true length. All the other position of lines have got the true length in either view, so it is easy to draw the projections. But in inclined to both the planes problems, none of the views has got the true length. So solving problems in this fourth position is more difficult than other positions. But there is a separate procedure to draw the projection in this case. You expect questions only from this fourth position. So in the next video, we will see the drawing procedure of the line when it is inclined to both the planes, and we'll solve the problems in it. If you have not subscribed the channel yet, support me by subscribing. Don't forget to click the bell icon. By doing so, you will get the notifications regularly. Also, share this video to your friends. Thank you.